Okay, so we like to argue, play with words, semantics it's called, just wordplay, and I do that also. We must always keep an open mind. If we get too intellectual, we miss out on a lot. For example, the word belief. I know what some people, I get that way too. They get, I don't believe in belief. It's an oxymoron, I guess. I don't believe in belief. Belief. Knowing. I do the same thing. But think of it like this also, right? It all depends on the context. If you have a friend, and your friend is experiencing some sort of weakness, and you tell your friend, I know you. Well, depending on what state of mind your friend is in, especially if your friend is in a weak state of mind, this, you telling them, I know you, may not necessarily be taken in the best way. It'll make your friend have to think too much, and then wonder, what you are exactly saying when you say, I know you. But if your friend is in a weak state of mind, and you look at your friend and you say, I believe in you. I believe in you. You see, so then now your friend will feel better about themselves. At least be consoled. Receive some solace. So we get caught up in so many things. A friend of mine on Facebook, he told me something. Scott Willoughby. It made a lot of sense. He said, don't focus on all those people who want to hate, throw hate vibes at you. Focus on those of us who are actually valuing what you are having to say and bring to the collective table. He's right. Because I cannot possibly please everybody. I am here because I have to be here. I'm not alone. I'm very sick right now. Right? Drinking tea. Very sick right now. But I'm not alone. I'm not alone. In my joys, in my sorrows, I'm not alone. None of us really are. We're not alone. I listen to my friends speak about their problems. And I'm not alone. So this little video is helping them if they see it. Because if they can see me, so simplistic as I am, trying, even in my sickness, trying to inspire them, then this is a good thing, and maybe then I can inspire them, right? I'm focusing on the first 3 days of this celebration to the great goddess, the great mother of the universe, called Navaratri. Nava means nine, Ratri means night, nine nights of the goddess. So the first 3 days I've been focusing on Kali. Then today, I guess, but I'm sick, I'm forgetting anyway, I'm still gonna do it. Today I started focusing on Saraswati, the goddess of wisdom and learning. The next 3 days I will focus on Lakshmi. So Saraswati means the flowing one. She is the goddess of wisdom and learning, of the music and the arts and the sciences. She is the eloquent one. She is the goddess of speech. She is the power, the very manifestation of the creative potency. We'd like to we like to cause separation between gods and goddesses. But really, they're all different aspects of the same glorious being. Another thing, most people won't agree, but some do. I'm not the only one in this. Durga. Again, the word, the name Shiva, is not even a gendered name. It's not male or female, but I want to say what I can say before this is over. Durga, in certain circles, which I am in agreement with, Durga, the word means beyond reach. And so I and others, you see, she is the goddess beyond all reach. Certain Vaishnavas will say, oh, Durga is the mother of the material energy, and Radha is the goddess of the eternal spirit, soul, being. Yes, but you know what? I differ slightly, you see. I don't bifurcate them. Radha is the very heart of Durga. So, in essence, they are the same. They are the same. We like to create distinction between material and spiritual. And this comes from a patriarchal frame of mind which seeks and has been seeking for the longest time to not only subjugate woman, but also I'm too sick to make sense, but I'm making sense nonetheless. Anyway, you cannot separate Shakti from Shiva, Shiva from Shakti. That is not possible. You can try. And there is a truth, a source that is beyond this daddy mama drama that we have. But it is through the mother and the father that we can reach this. But we can't skip them, you see. So herein is the mystery. So Durga, she manifests as the three goddesses. And she is also able to express all of them. Kali, Saraswati, and Lakshmi, she expresses all of them. And she also expands as each of them. But she herself can express and is expressing all of them. She is the source of all of them. And her consort is the greatest Shiva. There's so much stuff. So much stuff. Thank you, my friends. Not enough time to say what I have to say. Not nearly enough time. I wish I had enough time. But I don't. At least I'm not going to get cut off here. So much that I want to share. That's all I want to do. Share endless knowledge.